You are now listening to the Inner Circle Podcast Network.
Hashtag no offense uses strong language and is intended for a mature audience. Listener discretion is advised. Hashtag no offense.
Just typing Dr. D. I have Dr. Death, Dr. Demento.
Isn't Dr. Demento the guy that inspired Weird Al to be a thing? I think it is.
Do you think I know that?
I don't know. You're a white guy.
Guilty.
White people know about Weird Al. That's like our guy.
Do you need a drink?
No. I think I drank enough at work today.
How many times do you say that?
Every Friday.
Hi, guys.
Hello.
What's up, Dutchie?
Nothing. How was your day?
Good.
Dominic, your beard is looking full.
Thank you. And I am trying, I guess. Chris said I'm going full Almy because...
You got some curls going on.
Yeah.
Chris will call those sex curls.
Why did he get... Did you make him cut his hair or did he cut it himself?
No, he cut his hair himself. He was trying to grow a mullet, but then when the top wasn't growing in, he was like, I think I just better give up.
Just get some miracle grow for it.
He was shaving it for a while. I don't know what it is. I can't stand a shaved head. I don't like the touch of it. I don't like the look at it. That. It's just gross, right? And then he puts his head in your lap and you like just like prickly. Yeah. And I'm like, no. I'm like, your head does need to feel like my pussy after a couple days after I shaved it. Like, I don't like it. Not good.
Maybe one day I'll shave my head again. I feel like this is like receding back just far enough that it's not, it's not, this hair is not much longer for this world.
Oh, shut
That's
up.
Ponytail hair.
You have the hair of a hitman.
A hitman hair.
An aged hitman.
Aged?
So you have experience?
I'm like John Wick's mentor. Like, he comes to see me. We're like, I'm going hunting again. I'm like, all right.
John Wick's mentor. That's the straight to video joint.
He puts the X's on the maps for him.
He ain't a pirate.
Well, I guess you're right.
No, greyhounds can't climb stairs.
Is that true? That's not true. Is that really true?
Well, when I used to work at a dealership where they had a second floor, the boss would bring two greyhounds and he would have to carry each one of them up. But maybe they're old. I don't know. Maybe it's not true.
They're just lazy.
Big news.
If cows look up, they die. They just.
But their legs are just like super
long.
Yeah, so they can't.
Where'd you hear that about cows? That's not true.
That's true. It's farm wisdom.
When cows look up, they die.
If they look up, they die or whatever. In the rain, maybe?
Or whatever.
Oh, because they're dumb and they drown themselves.
If cows look up, they die or whatever.
Yeah.
Dying is the extreme. What is the whatever?
I remember when I was in like fifth grade in like health class, they made us do a report. You could pick what you did a report on. And I did it on the cows. Heart.
Oh.
And... Huh?
I thought you were going to say cows.
On cows. And it's I found out if they look up, they die immediately.
Or whatever.
Or whatever. No. It was like heart disease. And I remember like one of the symptoms, it was like shortness of breath, a tightness in your left arm, or death.
Oh.
And I was like, death is a symptom. That is a cool symptom to have.
That's a symptom of this reality,
That's
Dominic.
A final symptom.
It's always a symptom, like anal itching, death.
Right.
Anal itching and death.
Rectal
Just
bleeding.
Just give me death.
Yeah.
I would not want to itch. I couldn't scratch all day.
Dude, how about when like the back of your hand itches or your palm itches and you can't get it correctly? You know what I mean? Where you like, if you itch hard enough, it feels like you're going to tear your skin. Mm-hmm. And if you don't itch hard enough, it just makes it worse.
Or like when it's in your inner ear and you can't get in there.
I woke up at 2 o'clock in the morning this morning because I like tried to like rub my ear and I don't know. I just pushed a whole, I don't know what, just every bit of wax that's ever been in my ear. I pushed all the way in.
Oh no.
Ear out of that ear and couldn't fall back asleep for like 2 hours. It was awesome.
My God, that was awesome.
Who are you?
I watch those videos on Facebook where they take stuff out of ears.
That's all I could think about is like, I'm like, what kind of candle is in my ear right now?
We've done the earwax candles. Have you tried it?
She did that to me. Yeah, she did that
to me.
They
work.
They don't. Those are bogus.
They worked on us.
No, they didn't.
There's just stuff in there that looks like earwax. They have,
they're made of wax. That stuff that is in there, that is, because I watched about a million videos on that, and it is 10 times out of 10, the wax that you see that comes out is the wax that is made of that ear candle. Like, that's not from your ear.
But there was a ball that looked like the same color as his earwax. It was weird.
It was made of wax.
It was, but it was a perfect ball. It was so weird.
So I don't know if you could describe it as relief. And this is going to sound weird, but I like to just, I like to have shit done to me. And she's a picker. So like, I just like, I usually just sit there and let her like dick around on me. You know, she's fucking picking and shit and doing whatever. Yeah. So when she's like, I want to light this candle in your ear, I'm like, all right. And I just lay down. Just keep doing it. Just keep, I don't even care what you're doing. Just keep doing something.
Well, you know, when we like, first met, he used to have a lot of pimples on his back. So I'd like sit there and pop those, but they're better now.
I had a bunch of like blackheads on my face, and Beth would pop those like crazy. Dude,
I hate it.
Well, now I can't do it because you have that crazy beard. You probably have a whole bunch of.
You'll never know.
Those nose strips too. Pull all that stuff out.
Yeah, I don't care. I let her do whatever she wants, man.
And that's why Dr. Pimple, anyway. Pimple Popper is great, because do you guys watch? You guys watch that?
I've been trying to say it for like the last 10 minutes, because like I felt like this conversation was going that way. Riley hit me up this morning and was asking me, he just out of the blue, hey, can I ask you a question about your wife? Does she have any hobbies? And I was like, Not really. Like, when I'm in the studio, she's just watching TV. And I forget how it happened, but I was like, yeah, like, we do this thing called a podcast together, and I'd love for her to take an interest in that. But she's out there watching Dr. Pimple Popper instead. So, I mean, yeah, if you want to call her hobbies, that's her hobby.
That stuff is crazy.
I was mad because I had to download fucking Discovery Plus because that bitch only got new episodes on there now. It ain't on the Spectrum no more.
She went exclusive?
Yeah, dude.
I don't know if you can do it on TikTok, but I used to, on Instagram, just type in the search bar, like, hashtag blackhead extractions.
Oh. I do that on Facebook. Oh. Pimple pop videos.
What's
oh, yeah.
wrong with y'all,
sometimes,
dude?
I get so mad because the pixelation's so terrible.
Oh. Or how about the ones where they like, they tease you with the thing the whole time. They're like, here it comes, and it's over. Sorry.
And it's over. Yeah. There's a group that has like this big blackhead thing on the back, and then when you click to go in the group, like, it's not even real. It's not even a real thing. I'm like, this sucks. Those big old black kids, they're called like wine of something something.
Oh, whiner something whiners.
Yeah, wine of something or other. I don't know, but it was this one lady had one. And I think it was there for like 55 years or something.
What?
This old lady on Pimple Popper was on the side of her face, and it was so large and hard that they had to like cut the sides of it and to get it out.
Did I see this? You know. Was this where her skin was like a newspaper bag?
Yeah. And they I think her grandson went with her. She was a really nice old lady, but I was like, what?
What is the foot one that we watched for a little bit?
Oh, my feet are killing me.
Bro,
I've seen that.
That show made me, the next time I went to Walmart after watching that show, I bought like a little foot care kit. Like, I was horrified by half of one episode.
I can't. It was crazy because there's this also this guy on Hulu. The show is called Tojo. So it's just a guy and he just takes off like ingrown toenails and stuff. But like my feet are killing me is more surgery and like bone stuff. And that freaks me out. Like, I could watch you like take out an ingrown toenail or pop a cyst or take out a lipoma all day. But once you start like putting screws and bones and shit, I'm like, ooh.
Well, the guys like, you know, the guys that are like, well, my big toenail started growing and that was fun. And then it started curling over and came up and through my foot. And I don't know what to do now. It really hurts to walk. It's been like this for 18 years.
I feel like we just talked about ingrown toenails too, you and I, DJ.
Yes, because we were talking about, I was like mocking one of the guys about like he said he had an ingrown toenail and he couldn't come into work or something. Yes. And you were like, I legit had an ingrown toenail and couldn't go to work.
That's the lady. Ooh,
that's
my
it.
God.
Yep.
I was trying to figure out what it was called.
Spacers that you put in your ear.
Oh yeah, the gauge.
She gauged her temple.
Maybe that'll be the new craze. We'll just start gauging our pores.
A pour of whiner.
Pour of whiner is exactly right.
Well, why don't you take a pour of whiner and let's start this program?
All right, let's do it.
This isn't the whole show. We're not just going to talk about this the whole time.
I mean, she would be happy. Maybe this is how to get her interested in her hobby. Welcome back to the Hashtag No Offense Show. My name is Chris, joined as always by the lovely Duchess.
Hello.
This is, I think, like episode 163 or something like that.
Yeah.
I've been forgetting to name them.
It doesn't
matter.
Whatever. Apple don't like it.
Everybody doesn't like it, but I like it. So let's keep the one-star reviews coming. Episode 163, HTNOS.com, HTNOS on all the socials. We are joined by some special guests today. We've got Beth and DJ from Untrained Eye, the newest addition, the newest ring of honor to the Inner Circle podcast.
Oh, so we have 6 rings?
7, motherfucker.
Nice.
Do you still not count the plunge?
I forget about Elmy most of the time.
Ooh.
He's been releasing on a regular basis.
Semi-regular
sounds like a sex life.
I've been holding out. I wanted to get you guys in studio for our next appearance because it's been so long since our first collaboration.
Mm-hmm.
But the world being what it is and everything. I mean, like, you could have been here tonight. The invitation was open. I'm just saying.
But you've already been infected, so.
I'm just saying. I mean, like, as DJ's new pal and best friend, DJ Century, would say, he's probably just a little chicken little, right? He's just a little chicken little.
I will text Century right after this episode and we'll talk about it.
I bet you will. Here, let's get our business out of the way right up at the top. DJ, hey, do you want to do my hemp bombs read today? Since you're he's their number one client.
Hemp bombs is CBD, and I use it a lot, and I like it very much. High potency, one of those, and which one is it? The sleep one. Yeah, what do they call the sleep
melatonin?
One?
Melatonin.
You failed. You is failed, it, Dominic.
I don't know.
Don't tell him he failed. He's going to have to pop some gummies.
But yeah. Now that I can handle it.
Not exactly. So you built up that tolerance.
Finally.
Hashtag No Offense Show is sponsored by Hemp Bombs CBD. Hemp Bombs are specifically formulated to provide consumers with a quality CBD product at an affordable price. Many benefits of Hemp Bombs include reduced anxiety, increased sense of relaxation, reduction of aches and pains, mood enhancement, and deeper, more restful sleep. Hemp Bombs come in a wide variety of different products, including oils, gummy suckers, vapes, and even products for your pet. Use code HTNOS, that's HTNOS, at hemp bombs.com. Save 20% on your entire order. And I'm not bullshitting. DJ came to me and told me how Hemp Bombs changed his life. And I thanked him. I love to hear the positivity, the positive affirmations, because, you know, like, we've been accused of, like, we've been accused of, like, peddling snake oil and, like, the stuff doesn't really work. And, like, to hear the testimonials or whatever.
Well,
like,
when we first started slinging hemp bombs and you started taking it, I said right away that it totally increased, like, your mood. You were just a way better person to be around.
Chemically dependent. What can I say?
Mm-hmm.
What can I say? They do knock me out, though, too, man. I mean, we were...
I know. The snoring.
We haven't had them in a while. I haven't slept great lately, so... Need to get some more of them.
I slept on the couch one night because I'm like, I kept waking him up because he was just snoring and snoring. And I was like, I can't do this.
Yeah. Meanwhile, when she's snoring and snoring, I just deal with it like a goddamn soldier because that's called marriage.
No, because then you complain all the next day about how you didn't get no sleep.
That's also part of the deal.
No, bitch, you need sleep. Go on the couch.
No, that's part of the deal.
I go on the couch. I need my sleep.
Well, I'm better. Right, Beth?
Crickets.
Right, Beth? Yeah.
No.
She's like, yeah.
Like, DJ used to snore like super bad whenever he smoked, and then he lost a whole bunch of weight, and then now he's basically silent. But before it was terrible. I'm like, wake up.
Basically silent.
Well, we have one of those like adjustable bases, but I can't find the cord to plug it in because I used to just put it like up a little bit so that way he would stop snoring. But I can't find the cord.
Dude, when I had COVID.
You're around like Weekend at Bernie's.
When I had COVID and I was stuck in the bedroom, I wanted nothing more than to prop that bed up. And I was like, we've paid so much money for this bed that folds and we can't even use it. All I want in the world is to get folded up right now and I can't even have it.
Yeah, that sucks.
I feel your compassion and I feel us bonding right now. I feel the compassion through the screen, Beth.
I told him that that's what he gets for being a pussy and getting the Rona in the first place.
She's like, I don't know what you're feeling, player.
You got the Rona? Like,
probably from Dirty Girls.
There you go.
I don't know what he does during his day.
Care to elaborate?
I was waiting for a reaction.
He goes into a lot of 7-Elevens.
No, yeah, that's probably.
Oh, that's the deal.
Yeah, that's probably all it is. Just I'm in and out of a lot of gas Dirty stations girls. And those and convenience stores and all that for my day job. So no telling.
No, we're all fine. We ended up not getting it because we're no pussies.
How dare you?
My kids don't take medicine. What?
That's because you're mean.
Well, it seems to be working, so.
See? No, don't encourage her. She's mean.
Is it working?
Nope.
I never get sick.
As a COVID survivor, okay, I didn't even take any medicine when I was sick, okay? And as Jason always said, damn, bro, you white-knuckled COVID, so back the fuck off.
You know why you got sick, though? Because every time you get a little you're like, where's the Nyquil? No.
We ain't even going
there. Where's the Nyquil? I need both.
Hashtag no offense show is also sponsored by Onnit.com.
Nope, got it. Onnit, we're Onnit. Let's get Onnit.
Onnit is a health and fitness juggernaut dedicated to delivering complete and total human optimization. Through a wide array of products and supplements, Onnit combines cutting-edge science, earth-grown nutrients, and time-tested strategies to help people reach their peak performance.
I'm still waiting.
For what?
My peak performance.
That's hilarious.
I took my alpha brain 45 minutes ago. They should
I took
be...
some gut health. I should be peaking.
Peaking. A turtle head.
Visit Onnit.com. That's Onnit.com. And use code HTNOS to save 10% on whatever you choose to make yourself a better version of yourself.
Yes.
So, now, let's get to it.
Let's put our kettlebells down and get to it.
Guys. How the hell are you tonight?
Glad it's Friday. I know everyone's listening to this on Sunday or Monday or whatever, but...
Or not at all.
How dare you?
Why is he not listening to us ever?
No, DJ hates us. Oh. DJ, yeah. I don't even know how he agreed
to
this.
Are you the one-star review?
I'm one-star review. I'm AC204593 or whatever that guy's name was.
Mike 525 Rocket?
Yes.
Doritos! They're good.
I don't know why we are not all doing our own top fives just like that kid.
What would your first one be?
I don't know. Top five neon signs. Let's go.
Number five. Hashtag no offense, because I'm looking at it. Number four.
I remember Las Vegas, so the entirety of Vegas.
Because it's bright and I like it. Well, I'm glad that you guys are here. It sucks that we have to do it over the over the StreamYard, but you know, I was tired of waiting. And then when you signed on the dotted line, I mean, no time like the present, right?
Mm-hmm.
And I DJ and I were talking about this because we've become work husbands throughout the day. Like we stay on the phone. Now? No, we stay on the phone together all day while we're working. So
sweet. I can tell because I used to be able to reach him all day. Now I'm like, he's like, I'll call you back.
We were talking about it the other day, and I actually revisited the episode that you guys came on, and it was like almost 2 years ago. It was like a year and a half ago. It's so dated. And like I feel like we've come so far since then.
I mean, you guys lost a co-host. Like I think we were on the last or second to last episode that Two Rings was on, right? Because wasn't toward it the next end. Episode that he
yeah.
dipped?
Yeah, toward the end. It was on his countdown because she kept giving him shit the whole time.
About leaving?
About leaving, yeah.
Fucker.
But yeah, then like when I listened to it, I remembered, I was like, man, I was so sick that night. I remember just profusely sweating and like trying to get through it as quick as we can. And like, I remember after fact, I was like, we shortchanged them so bad. Like they're one of the first in-studio guests. And I was just like, oh, let's get this over with. I need to change my shirt. Like you guys came over with a pineapple and everything. And I didn't even mention it on the show. I was like, oh, this is so awesome. Oh, let's get this over with.
You were just nervous to meet us.
Well, absolutely. And that's how we started talking this week. I called your husband and I was like, listen, dude, no more of this nervous bullshit, okay? Like when you came over to the house the first time, you were all like, oh, I can't speak. Mom's the word. That's we're on the same team right now.
Fine,
we got jerseys on. We're on the same team. We got the same jerseys. Come on, let's just burn this motherfucker down. And he was like, okay, well, I don't know about Beth.
Sorry. One thing I think it's hilarious with you starting your show is that you don't ever give anyone a warning. So I would love to clear my throat. You're like, and we're going.
Yep. Yeah. You can always do whatever. I tell everybody, as soon as you pop in with us, we might just be shooting the shit, but know that it's being recorded. Like I hit record as soon as we get in here because you never know what's going to happen. I've been victim so many times to losing things and I'm like, damn, I wasn't recording. I mean, even tonight, I was a little slow hitting it, and he started talking about, like, motherfucker doom, and I'm like, damn, I missed the beginning of that. But anyway, I mean, like, we're here now, so, I mean, cheers. You don't have any drinks.
I don't have anything.
Beth's got that solo cup that I imagine has some whiskey in it.
I'm always so backwards. All right.
And whiskey and water.
Nice.
It's just water.
I was like, what kind of whiskey do you drink?
Oh, I drink whiskey. Jameson, I guess.
Yeah, I got some in the freezer. Why didn't you come over, Beth?
Well, you weren't talking to me all day. You were talking to DJ.
I need to get your credentials because I think this power couple, I know the way to the heart of it now. So, I mean, I'm just going to have to start going through you.
Okay.
Sorry, we're green bubbles. We don't accept your...
Oh, that's right.
You guys are sus.
Yeah. We want you in that chat so bad. Like Mikey's gonna get you like deals on iPhones through his work provider or something, dude.
What, Netflix?
Whatever movie he's working on.
I didn't know he did that. I wonder why their prices keep going up. Fucking give away iPhones and shit.
I told DJ, I said Mikey said he could get you an iPhone for half off, and he's like, it's still $500.
That's a lot.
That is a lot.
Back in the day, all you had to do was renew your contract. Now you gotta pay for the phone.
Yeah, it's ridiculous. Like I can't, it hurts to look at cell phones now. Like I think we paid like $400 or $500 for these Google Pixels, and every time it slips out of my hand, I just think, I'm like, am I going to get another one, or am I just gonna go full track phone and just give up?
Go ahead, Dutchie.
No, I would say we pay $100 a month just in phone payments.
Well, like it seems like it shifted. Before, like you had to pay for minutes and all that kind of stuff. And the phones were cheap, but now like the plans are cheap, but the phones are expensive.
Ah, I never looked at it that way because we're always paying so much fucking money anyway.
Dude, do you remember when you had to pay by the text?
Yes.
Like you'd run up a text bill. It's like, dude, just call me, man. But not till after 9.
After 9.
Weekends.
See, and when we started dating, she was in Indiana and I was in Illinois, so we were different area codes. And it was like, let's get a cell phone because then we won't have to pay long distance. Like, I had to pay long distance on my landline to fucking communicate with her.
Mm-hmm.
It was a lot.
That was worth it.
It was a lot.
Sometimes. It's just crazy how much technology has advanced with that. Like, at one time, my sister was staying over with us for like, I don't know, was it like 2 weeks or something?
Something like that.
And we had a phone plan where you could call long distance, but she didn't think we did. So she was calling someone in New York and she was using one of those like 10-10-220 numbers or something.
Yeah, the calling cards.
Yeah.
Dude, nobody. It's so funny because like no one gets that reference. That
was like $500 and we had a plan. So pissed.
Did you guys ever, did I ever tell it on the podcast? I don't know if I did. I was like, when the internet first came out and we had dial up, and my mom wasn't like a computer person, so she let me set the whole thing up, and we had like, it wasn't AOL, but it was like the Microsoft, it was like MSN or something, and it was the dial up provider, and I was just like clicking next to get through everything when I was setting it up, and I left it out, it's alphabetically, you had to call into the place, so it was set to Alabama, and I lived in Chicago, so every time I was calling to get online, it was calling Alabama, and at the end of the cycle, we had like a $2,500 phone bill. It was like thick, because like I would get on, check my mail, get off, get back on, like it was like all day long, like it was just fucking getting on. I came home and got my ass whooped, and then tried to get ahead of it, and I was like, it's, you can cancel it, and she's like, I don't need your fucking permission, it's gone.
So now do you read all the terms?
No.
Everyone does that. Next.
Exactly. But like, I don't know. I just, as what would I have been? 10, 11? I'm like,
something
I'm not.
Like that.
No, a little bit more than that. Probably like 12 or 13.
Oh, I don't know. Logan don't read shit neither. And he's 11.
Well, and that's why, yeah, he's got a phone too. So now he's factored into that. And that's why our overhead is so high on that.
Mm-hmm.
Older they get, I swear, man, the more expensive they get.
Yep. Now they say they need new shoes.
God, like, well, yes, we were sitting at dinner. And she said, tomorrow we got to take the boys for haircuts and new shoes. I was like, man, what did they do to earn those shoes?
I was like, walking the old ones? I don't know.
Are there even holes in them?
Yeah, just cut the fronts out of them and you're fine.
Yeah, give them some room to grow.
Yeah. When exactly. I met Chris, he had a pair of Chucks that were all duct taped together.
I was also a teenager, and I was also punk rock as fuck. So, I mean, back
trying
off.
Trying to be cool. Back I wasn't off. Talking shit. I was just saying, duct tape
just
does
back
like
off.
Wonders.
All right. Put me on blast in front of my new friends. Okay. Just back off.
Nah. That's not my style.
Well, we've been flirting with you guys for quite some time. What made you actually finally decide to come join the team, as it were?
The inner circle team, yeah.
Looking at me.
Yeah. Why did we? Because, I don't know. It was... it's funny because I think some people saw on Twitter that like the final domino anyway was Kaz. Like he kept adding the untrained eye just as like a side tweet to like, the inner circle, all these people, and also the untrained eye a little bit.
He's good for that. Yep.
Well, Kaz, we actually talked about it today. Kaz and I had like an unplanned, unspoken about recruiting trip for you that Friday, because that was the day. Like I called you last Friday and we talked for like a couple hours. And then after we hung up, Kaz dropped his episode and he tagged you. So like all those things like kind of like coincided. And then the Twitter fire came where like you put the eyeballs or something and then Adam went crazy. And next thing you know, it was like spun Imagine out of control. That. Like Adam's head was going like this, dude. Like he was whipped up into a frenzy. But like I was like, what? It's almost like the COVID stuff. I'm like, what changed? Like nothing happened, and all of a sudden everything's opening up. So like, what changed, man? Like you were like, nah, we're cool, and then all of a sudden you're like, you know what? Fuck it, we're squad.
I don't know. I mean, everyone has always been super cool to us for the most part. Like. In the inner circle, like everybody's been cool to us the whole time. And just in the podcasting community as a whole, I feel like have been pretty awesome to us. So I don't know. Like you guys are awesome. We're pretty awesome. I mean, why not?
True.
Combined forces.
Those are all valid points.
I know.
And I think too, like, I don't know. Like I'm kind of standoffish with new people. So listening to the shows, I'm like, oh, okay. I kind of know how they are. So it's not like. Just jumping into a team that you don't know.
Yeah. And that's actually something I told DJ too. I was like, you know, Joe B left last year and like, it's been an entire year before we even like brought you on. And I said, it's not like we want to add shows all the time. I explained it like when we do that, we're basically inviting somebody into, you know, like our
inner circle.
Yeah. Like into the mix. So it's like, can I see myself having dinner with this person and their spouse? Like, would we want to hang out? You know, like, it's like you, I mean, you guys see how tight we are. We get on planes and shit. Like, I mean, like we're legit friends, you know? So like extending that olive branch or whatever, you know, like it's a big deal, man. And we love y'all.
Dude, it's crazy. Cause like, listening to the Hood Diner today, like it, you know, we've heard a couple shows, you know, mentioned now that we are part of the inner circle, but it was crazy to hear because I've listened, you know, to all the shows for a long time, but to hear Kaz's like intro change and then our show become a part of that was crazy to hear. So I was like, wait a minute. Hold on.
This is what's going to happen. I'm going to make him re-record it. And then when everything's set, then I'm going to be like, all right, we quit.
Yeah. Oh, me and you. Is everyone settled? Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Deuce. That's what I originally said. I mean, I said it last week on our show. I was like, we quit. Or I won't say we. I said, I quit every week. I said, you can have my spot.
I don't quit because I just show up. I don't do any work.
That's what I said. You know, like I tried to say, you know, maybe this is your hobby. Take an interest. But
I said I'm boring. I don't have shit to talk about. I watch Netflix. Did you guys watch Don't Fuck With Cats on Netflix?
No, we didn't. Like, my cousin told me about it, and I don't know. Like, it seems a little bit too graphic.
It was just going to be cat videos. Yeah. Like, those crazy cat videos, because that Cat from Hell show is on, like, Animal Planet, where those cats are assholes. So I was like, don't fuck with cats. Okay, somebody's going to be teasing their cat, or you see those videos that they're, like, singing to their cat, and the cat bites them in the face and shit, and just, like, real mean. I totally thought that's what that was going to be. Like, don't fuck with cats, because they'll fuck with you, you know? I opened a whole can of worms, but I binge watched the shit out of it. It was weird.
Did you finish it?
Yeah.
I walked out there and she said she was watching it, and I was like, oh, that was all the rage like a year ago. Like, I deliberately didn't watch that. I had no interest in that. Carry on, ma'am.
I was just looking for something to watch because I binge watched everything else. That was a bad decision.
Did they show anything graphic on there? Because that's why I never wanted to watch it.
Yeah.
Start and then they don't show you, like, I don't want to say they don't show you the good parts, but they don't show you, like, you know, the actual happenings of what he's doing to the animals. But it's the crazy part is there was these people that started a Facebook group that pretty much stalked him and turned him into the police because they're like, this guy's gonna escalate and kill somebody else, and it happens, and it's a person.
He killed a person?
Yeah, he ends up killing a person, and it's insane. This guy was so into himself, and he made all these fake accounts. Like, he was trying to be, like, a model and an actor and all that stuff. So he made all these fake accounts, all these fanboy accounts and stuff about himself. It was crazy. He'd Photoshop pictures that looked like he was traveling the world. And
he didn't live in New Hampshire, did he?
No, he lived in Canada.
Okay. I was going to say, you sound like you're describing, you know, somebody that we all know.
No.
Did you guys watch The Night Stalker?
Yeah, I watched that. I binge watched that too. That dude was ugly as fuck.
What is that? That sounds like a superhero.
He was not.
He was like a superhero, but like bizarro superhero.
Opposite. Well, he was a super villain.
The Night Stalker sounds like a character from The Boys. I don't know.
No, it was about a guy that he was a serial killer too, but he would molest children. He would murder couples. He would take girls. I mean, he just did everything.
Like, remember that guy, Antoine Dobson, that was like, they're raping everybody out here.
Yeah.
It was like the embodiment of that. He was just like indiscriminately killing anything that he saw.
Right.
So that's who he was talking about? Antoine Dobson was talking about the Night Stalker?
He might as well have been.
But, like, I don't want to spoil it for anybody.
They caught him.
Spoil.
I mean, it was
spoil.
Like, oh, yeah. Years, 30 years ago.
Yeah, it was a long time ago, yeah. But then, like, when they described him, they're like, oh, yeah, he smelled like a goat. I'm like,
ew. Yeah. Yeah, I just like how they caught him, how, like, he was out of town or whatever, and then he didn't know that they were even looking for him.
Yeah.
So then he's so arrogant. Came back, people were like, it's him. And the people caught him.
The whole town pretty much came together and caught him.
Everybody rolled on him, huh?
Mm-hmm. Yep. They cornered him, and then he got in the back of the car.
Whenever he was in the back of the cop car, he had on, like, gauze over his head.
Yeah, somebody grabbed
him. Oh, no. Well, I mean, I guess mob rules, right? Yeah, he had it coming.
He murdered a lot of people.
Yeah, he did.
And probably more. Well, they've said probably more than what, because he would jump counties in California. So there was a lot of unsolved that probably was with him, too.
Unsolved mysteries.
But then he was a sex symbol, and he was so gross.
Yeah. Well, especially, like, how can you make someone a sex symbol that's a pedophile?
Dude, bitches, like, are crazy. I know.
Or smells like a goat. She said he smelled like a goat, and he's a goddamn sex symbol.
And his teeth were
fucked up. He's a man's man.
His teeth were, like brown and black and stuff. Ew, and, like, it was gross. Like, when they showed the picture of him because they made him smile, I was like, ooh.
You know,
it's the worst.
You know, like, I you guys know this. I'm not telling you anything new. This is not breaking news. But, like, women are weird, right? Like, you guys, like, fall in love with, what's his name? The killer?
Ted Bundy?
Ted Bundy. He's so charismatic. Oh, my God. He's so
hot. I get that one.
He's a murderer.
I get that one. I think he was hot, like, for the time. Sure. But, like, if he was out right now.
What time was it?
If you got Zac Efron playing your character, you're fucking hot.
Okay, right? Well, Zac Efron is different. Like, that's not the real guy.
That's who would play me.
No.
Zac Efron? Yeah.
John C. Reilly, bitch.
Mr. Cellophane.
Okay, everyone said that I looked like Costanza from Seinfeld. So
not
that
even
was
a little. Not even a little. Who told you that?
That started in high school. So that was a pretty cool thing.
Were you round and bald back then?
I was round and short. And that was enough. And Seinfeld was big enough that they were like, you're Costanza. I was like, no.
Not even.
All right. Fucking you guys need to get a portrait of DJ in his underwear like Costanza. Hanging over the, hanging on that wall back there.
I would push an old thing over if there's a fire.
Oh my God, that's hilarious. Like, I've never seen that show really, but except for that scene.
The Seinfeld show?
Yeah, oh. I didn't really watch it.
That used but to be our rerun jam.
Push the old lady down because he thought there was a fire.
That used to be our rerun jam.
It's such a fun show. One episode, Kramer goes to the roof and bastes himself in butter. And then he's like, what's cooking? And he's like, oh, it's me. Or he puts a garbage disposal in his shower so he can make salads while he's showering.
I thought about you guys were talking about Kenny Rogers Roasters recently, and like it made me remember when I saw that on Seinfeld. I thought that that was like for the show, and then DJ, you were like, no, that's a real place. Like,
it's the wood that makes it good.
Like, was that a Southern thing? Because we definitely didn't have that in Chicago.
I have no idea. Like, it might have been, because like I remember the first time someone said the word Wawa to me, and I was like, are there rocks in your mouth? What does that mean?
Right.
Like Helen Keller. Wawa. Wawa. That's terrible.
They got good sandwiches though.
Dude, they're the greatest. Like, the every other convenience store should just shutter. Like, they should be done. Wawa is ridiculously so much better. But it's just crazy that there are like guys in like that are almost 50 years old. They're like, I remember going to Wawa as a child.
I never saw
the first Wawa until I was in my 30s.
Right. Well, it was only in Pennsylvania and New Jersey. Like, they just came here within the last couple of years. And Florida is legit the only other state besides New Jersey and Pennsylvania, I believe.
Oh, really?
Uh-huh.
Dude.
Yeah, that is true, because we sell a lot of cars to them.
To Wawa? New
Jersey, Pennsylvania. Yep.
No kidding.
That's correct.
Well, Chris, what are you going to do with that information? Go ahead. Fill it out for us, please.
Is that something I shouldn't have said?
You know what? You guys like trivia. They're building the first drive-through Wawa in Orlando in the country. It is a drive-through gas station.
What's that got to do with trivia?
Because sometime that's going to come up as a trivia question, and he's going to be like, oh, I know where the only drive-through gas station is. That's fucking Orlando.
Oh,
from the 90s, though?
I'll never.
That's where trivia's from.
Time is a construct, Beth.
I mean, semantics.
Wait, so aren't they all drive-throughs?
No, like for the sandwiches.
Come on, son. They already have Beverage Castle for that.
Sandwiches?
Dude, Beverage Castle is obsolete. Those things don't exist anymore, dude. All the Beverage Castles turned into like oil change places and things.
Or car washes.
Was Beverage Castle was that just a Southern thing too, or was
absolutely
that all
over? Yes. We came here on vacation one year and I was like, oh, it's a liquor store you could drive in?
And we did.
Yeah, and paid an extra $3 for the experience.
I think I got a Gatorade. We didn't even get alcohol. I didn't drink back then. Now I drink all the time. We should go now.
The greatest part about a Beverage Castle was like they had the flunkiest that worked there. And I remember many times signing. I remember there was a dude, he was in like a DUI class or like an AA class or something, and he needed signatures from it, but he didn't get them or didn't go to the class or whatever it was. We were like 15 or 16 years old, and he would sell us beer as long as we would sign his paper.
What?
For like, yeah, like a sponsor?
I don't know what it was. He was just like, will you sign this? And I signed Donald Duck, and I was like, there you go.
It was probably your community service.
Oh yeah.
That's funny.
And then he turned it in and DJ got him like in trouble because he put Donald Duck on it.
I mean, it looked, it was very fancy cursive. So it looked, I mean, you'd really have to look at it to be like, who, Don, what?
Donald Duquesne?
Like whenever I used to work at this Buick dealership, they used to have people come in and like do like a sale or whatever, and they would bring their own salespeople. And somebody called in and they're like, I'm trying to reach London Bridges. And I'm like, what? Like, I thought they were playing a joke on me, but it was really someone's name.
Oh, wow.
Oh, I was waiting for you to say like someone put a fake name. It was really their name?
No, it was really the guy's name. Yeah. I'm like, okay, hold on.
A guy's name.
I'm like, wait, is he falling down? What's happening?
Was he a salesman?
Yeah.
Of course he was. Wow. You cannot have a name like that. You either die or you become the strongest human being alive with a name like London Bridges.
Now, the question then stands, like, what was wrong with your parents? Because they knew what they were doing.
Yeah, there's no an accidental, like, Michael Hunt situation. Like, you have named your kid London Bridges.
And I'll tell you, Beth, the DJ doesn't believe me. DJ doesn't believe me, but my best friend in the world since we were kids is a guy named Nicholas Smicholas.
And the guy that doesn't exist. Go ahead.
He doesn't believe me that this person exists. And I was like, he does. Actually, ironically enough, today's his birthday. So shout out to you, Nick Smick. DJ thinks you're a fairy tale person, but I promise you, he's real.
You're an imaginary friend, Nicholas Pickles. You do not exist.
And I told him, you said he doesn't exist. And he laughed. He said, ha ha.
Well, I thought that was like the best name ever until I got an email from somebody named Nick Knickerbocker at work. Knickerbocker. And I was like, I don't know which one's better.
Who does that?
Or worse.
Who does that? We were going to name our oldest Logan Dean and decided against it because his initials would be LD.
For learning, what is that? Learning disability.
By the way, it's been that long since I've been in school because I never would have got there as a 37-year-old man.
I don't think most people would because most people are like, what's that mean? But I know like growing up in the 90s, we would like mess with each other. We'd call each other, be like, oh, you LD.
Mm-hmm. It doesn't matter what your name is. It doesn't matter what your initials are. I was DJ and that was it. Like my thing was like, it wasn't even mocking me. Like I remember every adult, when they met me, it's like, DJ, like the guy on the radio.
Oh, geez.
You know,
oh, no.
Be DJ if you went on the radio.
See, and I think DJ Tanner. I never even think DJ Radio.
Oh, that was great. I loved when that happened, when DJ Tanner showed up. And what is it? The other one. What was the kid? Or is it Tanner? Who was the girl that was on Full House?
Kimmy Gibbler.
No, there was a DJ. DJ it was something.
Yeah, Cameron Candace.
Who was the DJ on? Because no one ever thought of him.
Oh, on Roseanne?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Forget about that.
If you had the choice to pick between Candace Cameron and the little squirrely kid from Roseanne, why would you ever go that way?
But what I'm saying is, I have the same name as them.
I know. But when you're thinking about DJs, I'm like, I'm going to go Candace Cameron 10 out of 10 times. Fuck that little kid.
Yeah, but if I had to choose, they're like, hey, you're a girl named Guy in fifth grade, or you're some trailer trash nonsense person that lives with Roseanne.
They had a house. You just couldn't pay their bills.
They had a house like most people in Dutch's neighborhood.
My mom did the best she could, okay?
were the youths fed bologna to coyotes under the porch?
That was an accident. I thought it was a dog.
Like, what are you, one of the Rockefellers?
Don't put that evil on me.
Right.
Don't you put that evil on me. They are one of the controlling families in the New World Order, and how dare you put that,
oh, okay,
how dare you put that out here? That fake news on the hashtag No Offense Show. You think you're breaking conspiracy theories? Ha! I shoot that down immediately.
Okay.
Are you saying your last name is Whataburger? Is that what you're saying?
The one. I wish it was, dude. I would have a chain of fast food restaurants for like yesterday.
I'm so glad it's not. Whatsky's bad enough. I'm so glad.
How dare you? I made you so much cooler just by giving you my name.
Oh, you didn't give nothing to me. I took it.
How dare you?
I'm just kidding.
Are you guys excited for the Tampa Super Bowl?
Yeah, super excited. Very sports oriented over
the
end.
I was going to say, does DJ even like football? Do you even like football? You don't strike me as the type that does sports or like sports at all.
He went on a tirade with me the other day, or was it today? He was like, the best part about COVID, didn't even realize it. Sports was gone. Didn't have to hear about it. It's like,
yeah, that was, it was like the unintended great thing that happened. It's like, I was spoiled for the last 10 months or whatever, when I didn't have to hear about one ball being hit anywhere or anyone catching it or touching it or not touching it. Like every once in a while, there were a couple guys that kicked each other in the face and that was about it. And that's fine. That's, that sport is okay. Cause it's, you know, somebody's bones fly out of their body. And that's awesome.
That's not how that works.
Are you telling me that teeth don't ever fly out of people's bodies in those fights?
Semantics.
Bones.
Semantics. But it's historic, man. You got to at least root for history, man. First what? Time in history.
What?
Yes. What?
History? Yes. Are you a Make America Great Again person? What are you talking about?
You both have that's two strikes in like 5 minutes, all right? You need to settle down or I'm going to end this transmission.
He's lying. He wouldn't.
No, it's all bark. It's historic, okay? Florida man Tom Brady is in the Super Bowl, and it's Tampa in Tampa. It's a big deal, man. Our community. Come on, our community.
I feel that they threw the game. That everything's a conspiracy theory. Because why would the Packers do that on the third down and
kick instead of going? Dumb.
No.
Didn't we have the chance back? Because when was the last time it was in Florida and we were, in Tampa and we were like this close?
Six?
Eight, I believe. Eight. 2007, 2008, something like that. I don't think we were that close. I think
there was one time when I feel like it was going to be in Tampa and we, like, the Bucks were super close.
Yeah.
Maybe I'm wrong, but again, like, all my sports news I get tangentially from sports radio that someone else is listening to in a car that passes by every now
and then. Yeah. Super specific, bro. I mean, like, but you don't even, like, get caught up in, like, the Super Bowl hoopla, like, you know, who's at the halftime, who, gambling
and the commercials.
Any of the peripheral stuff?
Let me put it in context for you. When the Janet Jackson nip slip happened and was heard around the world, do you know what Beth and I were doing? I'll give you two guesses as to what we were doing.
Is it X-rated?
It is not. It is possibly the least X-rated thing you could be doing.
Reading a book.
Close.
Playing video games.
We were doing crossword puzzles.
Nice.
Because we didn't even know that the game was on. And then the next day they were like, you missed it. Janet Jackson was kind of naked for a second and you missed it. The internet's so new, you can't even find it there. Sorry.
Whoever told you that's a dickhead. Oh, man, the weekend's going to be in Tampa. I want to go down to Ray J and see if I could catch the weekend, dude. I love that guy.
Catch the COVID again? What?
No, I'm bulletproof, all right? Stop it. Hunter told me I'm good till April.
Hunter?
He's an op. Okay,
well, there you go.
I put all my stock in the plunge, kids. I put all my stock in the plunge, kids.
I don't know why.
We were at dinner tonight, and we were at Buffalo Wild Wings, and across the TVs, I saw that somebody put down a $2 million bet on the Bucks on the game.
Wow.
Was it the same guy that lost? Who's the guy that bet all the money on that one fight a while back? He, like, had big stacks of money.
The McGregor deal?
Maybe. Oh, yeah. It was McGregor and the other guy. What was his name?
The other guy's fine.
The boxer guy. What is his name?
Mayweather.
Mayweather. Oh, yeah. And he had, like, that big, like, table full of cash, and he was like, I'm betting it all on the guy who's definitely going to win, and then he lost it all. Was it that guy?
Probably not, because he lost it all.
Double or nothing.
Peddling for pennies.
It wasn't Jeff Bezos, but it was like a Jeff Bezos type character. It was a guy that, like, Mark even Cuban. Though he lost an incredible amount of money, it doesn't really matter to him, I would imagine.
Was it like Dan Bilzerian or something?
Maybe.
That's a real person?
Yeah, who is that?
He's that guy that he's on Instagram all the time with chicks in bikinis shooting guns.
I don't follow him.
And he's got lots of money.
Oh, is that the old guy with the beard?
No, he's the young guy with the beard.
Oh, I don't know who that is. Isn't that the family's name from Big Mouth? Balzerian? The one
Nick
that...
Kroll? Oh.
Yeah, the Kroll show?
I don't know much about that show other than the demon, the hormone demons or whatever.
No, it's the one that has all the boys. The mom that has all the boys. And
oh, the
like,
guy that the guy that
the guy that fucks pillows.
Yeah, and then had to get a divorce from his pillow.
Yeah,
and he then had to pay child support on the baby pillows.
It was gross.
It was pretty funny. Yeah. And then there was a couch cushion, and then the pillow and the couch cushion like fought over him.
They had a three-way. Like, oh, they, yeah. They had the couch and the pillow get the kid with a three-way. It's a very weird but show.
The guy who plays that character is Rafi from
The League.
The League. Oh,
is that the guy with the curly hair?
Yes.
That looks like a crazy person. Yes. Why can't? What is his name? Do you remember?
Rafi.
No, he his looked, real name.
No, his real name. It's a cool name too. It's like I feel like it might be very Greek.
Like Rafi.
You know what? I don't know why you're like this, but I'm glad we're all part of the same team now.
I am whatever you say I am.
All right, Eminem, take your ass back to 8 Mile.
So I want to make a phone call, if you guys don't mind.
Oh, no.
Who are you calling?
Well, here's the thing. The GameStop thing happened this week with the stocks. Well, here, let me, Beth, you look like a woman who might be able to tell me what a hedge fund is.
No.
Damn it. No one like, can I've tell me what a hedge fund is. Where
people try to explain that, and I'm like, okay, well, I don't even know if that's wrong what you're saying. No idea.
So I got the gist of what happened here, but I don't know why the people on Wall Street are upset other than they lost a lot of money. And I wanted to call Mikey from Failing Hollywood about it because he's very deep into this like stock trading world and he's been following it very closely, but they're also recording right now. And I told him I didn't want to do like a Podception type scenario, but...
What about Ross Trudy?
Well, he's part of that podcast that's going on right now, so I'm also not going to call him. But I mean, like on the roster, we have a doctor and a lord, so I figured maybe he might know what a hedge fund is.
I mean, I don't know what a hedge fund specifically is, but what's happening is they bet that some stocks are going to fail, like GameStop,
right,
was going down. So they're like, oh, we're going to bet that these stocks are going to fail. And we're going to sell them and then try to buy them back once they're lower.
Okay. So they're gambling.
But
so some
since people know that, they're like, well, we're just going to buy them now and then raise them back up. So you can't do that. And so that's causing like a gap in between people like buying and selling them at a lower rate. So they're losing like billions of dollars.
Yeah. 70. The last I heard, they are losing upwards of $70 billion because I know nothing about this, but like the podcast I listened to about it was like kind of how it works is like what she was saying about how you like short those stocks or whatever. Yeah. So if they do go down, then you can make that money back. But if they go up, like the higher they go up, you can only make so much money on the stock depending on how much you pay for it, but you can lose infinitely. So that is why they are freaking out, is because there's basically no end to how like deeply that they could just be screwed. Is my like super cursory understanding of what is going on. So people are losing their minds, and with things like Robinhood, that app telling people that they can't buy shares for whatever reason it is. I've heard more than a dozen people talk about how that is just, we are openly seeing the, how do they say it? Things that are supposed to be happening in this game behind closed doors. Everything is happening so fast because of the internet that we can't, they don't even have time to do these things behind closed doors. Like that shouldn't be allowed to happen. You know what I mean? Like they shouldn't.
Which part? Like stopping the sales or the people like jacking up the stock prices on businesses
so
that are going to fail?
They're not stopping the sales. Or I'm sorry, they're not stopping. They are stopping. No. They stopped. You're not able to purchase anymore through Robinhood, but you are allowed to sell it.
Yes.
So what's crazy is who are they selling it to? If you can't buy it,
yeah.
So
there's like, so much fuckery going on, and dude, I don't get it. I read the compilation Cliff Notes article, like everything you need to know about what's happening with the GameStop scenario, and I read some terms and I got real deep into this article and found out I'm like, I don't know what is happening. I'm such a bad adult. I don't know anything about the stock market.
The greatest part about it is two things. One, there are some like people that have been like on the edges of like knowing about stocks or whatever, like they have become literal not even over, less than overnight millionaires. Like, people have become wildly rich off of this. But it all started apparently off of some like subreddit that just follows Wall Street, and somehow they caught whiff of that, you know, that stock being sold short. And they were like, okay, just kidding. We're not going to let that happen. Let's go. Because there was at least a million people in that Reddit or that subreddit. And they pretty much all got on it and were like, let's go. And then what Elon Musk tweeted out about it. And it just went crazy.
Dude, like, Florida man bought what do you call it when the airplane has the thing behind it, like the sign behind it? Is there like
a, oh, like a
other than airplane sign, a banner?
Yeah,
yeah. I was, other than airplane sign, I didn't know if there was like a proper term for it. Florida man bought one that just says buy GameStop stock and flew it like all over Miami for like the last couple days. Like,
I mean, listen, I will say this about stocks: anytime that you don't know anything about stocks and you hear a great tip on a stock, do not do anything with, if you're listening to this, don't buy GameStop stock. You will lose everything. Like, there's no such thing as a hot tip. If someone is telling you that they're like, hey man, I just heard about this thing, your friend's an idiot. Don't buy it unless he is a known stock person. Don't do this. Like, that guy with the banner is going to make people go completely bankrupt.
Oh, believe dude, in your I woke up this morning to a text from the homie casual, and it said, bro, did you have any GameStop stock? And I'm like, you know, goddamn well, my history with GameStop is checkered. Don't even like question me about like things involving GameStop. And he's like, well, what about the dog coin? And I'm like, the fuck is a dog coin, bro?
There you, it's Dogecoin, you son of a bitch.
I don't know anything, okay? But like, I told him, I was like, I can't get involved with this because I am a gambling degenerate. I really am. I got into Bitcoin when it, like, not when it first happened, but like fairly early on. I bought some Bitcoin, not even like a whole Bitcoin, but like you know, we put a few $100 in, I think it was. And as soon as it like did anything, like it dipped immediately. Like we put money in and then it went down immediately. And I was like, fuck, like I'm just watching the app every like hour I'm refreshing it. And I'm like, what's it doing? What's it doing? And as soon as it got back up to where I could get rid of it, I'm like, I'm out. My heart can't take this. My heart can't take this. I'm done with it. And I told Kaz, I was like, if it would have went the other way, if I would have went up immediately and started seeing a return, my kids wouldn't be able to eat. Like, I would legit take everything I had and start, like, parlaying it into fake internet currency. Like, it would be over.
It's like, yeah. Dude, you should or get a little. Or maybe would be rich. Like, what about that person that can't find their password to access, like, what is it? Like, $2 million or $1 billion or whatever?
Yeah.
And they said something one like, more try.
Yeah, like, if they try again, they're locked out forever or something.
Damn. Yeah, like, you can't call customer service.
Like, I never saw Ready Player One, but I feel like.
Oh, watch it. Watch it now. What's wrong with you, bro? Come on.
Everything is wrong.
That's a really good movie.
I watched it again the other day. It's great.
Like, I read half of the book.
I heard there was like controversy of the book because the people don't like the author for some reason. I'm not exactly sure. They're like, what I love about people talking about guys like that, that write stories like that. One of the things that they said about this author was they were like, his portrayal of women is not correct. It's just, it doesn't make any sense. It's not how an actual woman would act. Oh, really? In the virtual world where you just go to, I don't know, drive a DeLorean in a race or whatever they do in that movie, that the women weren't portrayed correctly.
Oh, geez. Oh.
Okay.
Well, see, this is how I personally skirt around that, is because I never read any books. So then when I see the movie, I have nothing to compare it to. And I can just accept it for face value because it's great and I'm watching it. And I can't go, it didn't follow the story. God damn it. I like the book better.
Well, sometimes the books are better.
Well,
do you read Dutchie?
No.
She has no hobbies, remember?
Like, I don't read as much as I used to.
The only book I ever read was Jaws, and I was really surprised because in the movie there's no glistening vaginas like there is in the book.
Steven, so when you got raw.
The book first?
Yeah.
And then made it into a movie? I didn't know that.
Well, I read the book before I saw the movie. I don't know which came first.
So which was more horrifying?
Well, I was blinded by vaginas in the book, so I don't even think I finished it. And then I just saw the movie and there was blood everywhere. So, but it's like my all-time favorite movie. I do. It's my favorite movie. Yeah. I quote them all the time because, like, even my friend that sits next to me, she'll say something. And I'm like, yeah, because you can't just be like, y'all know me. know what I do for a living. I just quote shit sometimes.
I saw a Jaws story and I forgot to send it to you. You know the mom of the kid who dies?
I saw that.
Yeah, and she went to a restaurant and there was a sandwich on the menu of the character from the kid. Like, she was the mother of this kid that died by a shark. You've seen Jaws, yeah?
Yes.
Okay.
It was the kid that went out on the yellow raft and got eaten.
Yeah. And she went to a restaurant, like, recently, and there was a sandwich on the menu with that kid's name. And she made, like, a comment to the waiter, like, you know, like, oh, I played that kid's mom in the movie. They went and got, like, the owner of the restaurant, and it was the actor that played the kid in the movie, and that was the first time they'd seen each other since they did the movie.
I was That's like, crazy.
And you tell That's me it's universe. Not a simulation, Dominic. That doesn't happen.
There's coincidences.
But whose simulation is it? Like, I haven't seen Jaws since I was a child.
Well, and the guy has to work afterwards. Like,
right.
Yeah, what was it? One of the... One
he
of
didn't
the,
die in real life.
What are the odds, though? Come on. Let's be real.
One of the Sandlot kids, he, like, owns or used to own, like, a sandwich shop around here.
Well, it's a pizza place called Villarinas.
There you go.
Like, it's off of 60.
Is it really? Which kid?
It was one of the twins.
Yes.
Oh, one of the whack ones, dude.
Oh, it ain't Squints or nothing.
I don't know. Tell me.
No, it wasn't the main cute one.
We used to see those kids in the mall sometimes, like that one twin kid or whatever when we were kids. And by the way, this is why, like, there is that rift between, like, actors and normal people, because we would just yell in this kid's face, to the Sandlot, and just run away. Like,
dude, I tell you what, man, that's so weird, because it wouldn't affect Dutch, but when we were growing up, one of the kids from the Mighty Ducks went to the next high school over. So, like, he was around and, like, in the mix a little bit. And we would see him, and he was such a dork. Like, he got bullied after the Mighty Ducks. Like, he should have been the coolest kid ever. The Mighty Ducks was awesome. It was, like, 95. Like, he should have been.
Goldberg?
No, it was Averman. It was Averman.
Oh, like, Averman?
Yeah, it was Averman, the kid with the glasses.
I don't remember.
And he was always going, swing, batter, 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 swing, batter, batter. He's like, there's no batter.
He was the one with the glasses and the curly red hair.
Oh, okay. I do know who you're talking about.
I can't not see Squints. Like, I only see Squints.
Yeah, whatever. Me too.
why couldn't the big green or whatever that fat kid, why couldn't he have a restaurant in town? I'd go see him.
The one that's like, you're killing me, Smalls.
Yes.
That kid, or not that kid. There was another kid. Do you remember when they remade The Little Rascals into a movie?
Yes. Yep.
And the kid that played Alfalfa's name was Bug Hall.
Didn't know that.
I almost knew that because I got a buddy that knew him, and, like, he was from around here and hung out with him. And I have no stories about it. I just know that there is a kid that exists named Bug Hall.
Yep, I remember that.
Never would have knew that one.
No, but old Goldberg got arrested recently for, like, drugs or something, and he's all, like, skinny and his skin's falling off his bones. Like, he looks terrible.
Well, I think they, like, did I don't know if it was a GoFundMe or something to get him some, like, new teeth. I think he's cleaned up now.
Oh, that's good. Good for him.
Yeah. But so he's got a new grill.
Hey. I would have never, if he was on the corner in Tampa looking for quarters, I would have never guessed it'd be him.
Dude, you guys were talking homeless guys this week, and it reminded me. Have you caught the guy by Brandon Mall?
No, I don't go by Brandon Mall. Really?
Well,
then I take it back.
Excuse me, DJ.
I don't go on. I avoid the mall at all costs. Like, I'm barely ever on 60, and the closest I get is Causeway to make very little
differences. Okay. Well, it was at the Causeway entrance to the mall. Smart guy. Okay, Mr. I don't go by the mall.
I only pass by when it's dark outside and it's cold, and they don't like to be out when it's cold.
So. I actually took a picture. I was at the stoplight, and I took a picture and sent it to the IC group chat. It's this guy standing with a big poster board that said he was looking for money to start his new career as a sports agent. And I was like, points for creativity, bro. Like, if I had something, I'd probably give it to you.
Don't do it. Don't do it.
But it's not like we'll work for food or whatever. He's like, I'm trying to be Jerry Maguire, motherfucker. Give
You're
me a dollar.
You're going to see one holding the sign that says GameStop stock next.
Probably all these out of work hedge fund managers now or whatever.
Dude, it's crazy. We built a pool for a guy a long time ago in like 2008, right before the housing bubble popped. And this dude was a hedge fund manager. And that dude, he had a $1 million house that he did cash. like $800,000 extra dollars for just whatever upgrades that he wanted.
Wow.
And that dude lost so much that after like he had like a he did like half a draw that was like $20,000 and still like called my boss and was like, hey man, I need that money back. And my boss was like, nah. Right. You already gave me half. You're getting nothing from me.
Well, and see, and that's what I wanted to say when we were talking about it too, is like, I kind of like that punk rock part of my brain is kind of like, yeah, damn the man. Fuck you guys. I'm glad that a bunch of guys on an internet message board were able to band together and take down something on Wall Street, dude. They pushed a failing company into the Fortune 500. GameStop is now a Fortune 500 company, and it was on the brink of going out of business. Now, I know it doesn't mean anything because they just inflated meaningless stocks or whatever, but they made a change. You know, like that's crazy.
And it shows what we are capable of. Like, we have this idea that, like, because we are told that, you know, stocks and bonds are for the rich or the, you know, the stressed, the guys that want to go out there and throw papers up in the air on Wall Street or whatever they do there. And like, and it's not, it's just clearly not that. Like, the podcast I was listening to, the guy was like,
it's white collar gambling is what it is. And that's okay. But the guy that dresses in a track suit and looks like Adam Simmons that goes down to the dog track, he's looked down on, but they're literally doing the same thing.
Well, and when now that the guy in the track suit has decided to play the same game as the guy in the three-piece suit, all of a sudden we're like, whoa, 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 whoa. We need to change the rules. We just can't have riffraff coming in here. Exactly. Buying stocks, getting to be a millionaire. That is not why this exists. This isn't for you, tracksuit man.
Go bet on the Jets or something. Stay in your lane.
Yeah. Bet on the Super Bowl. $2 million. It'll be great. You'll win. The Bucks will definitely not choke. Not 1 second. They're not known for choking. They never choked in the past. They're not going to choke now. But it's going to be great.
Tom Brady now.
Dude. I don't know how the spread is so close. Like, as a degenerate, I'm looking going, I wish I could bet Kansas City all day. It's only like a 3-point spread, and I have a feeling they're going to win by more than 3 points.
I don't know what you just said right now. I don't know what any of that means.
Well, Dominic, let me get my tracksuit out.
I learned because he talks to me like I'm interested, but then I learn things, and then I become interested.
Her hobby is yeah. faking that she is interested in her husband.
Well, how do you think we have all these pops back here? Like, that just happened overnight. Like, all of a sudden, there's like, wait, there's Dirty Dancing ones? There's Goonies ones? There's
Romeo the Simpsons? And Michelle?
Hey, let's go.
I saw Joss Pops, and I was like, what? They have one of the shark eating the guy when the boat goes up in the air, and he's, like, falling into the shark's mouth.
That stuff is cool. Those are cool.
It was, like, $130. I'm like, I kind of want it.
See, ones like that are cool. Like, I always said I wouldn't ever get like one of just a regular person because I'm like, with their dumb big black stupid eyes, like they're not cool. And then last weekend I bought a Shaquille O'Neal pop because god damn it, I'm a Shaquille O'Neal mark. I'm a fanboy since the 90s for Shaq, and I saw one at Target and I was like, I took a picture of it and I sent it to Kaz and I was like, fuck you. He's like, got him.
Dude, yeah, he did get
that's
you.
That's how it gets you.
You're going to start now. Congratulations. No. It's going to be all pops on the back of that wall there.
Look, I got two. I'm looking at them right there. I got Baby Yoda and I got Shaq. Other than that, I got Christmas decoration pops. They're gone. Yeah. They're gone.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, 100%. So I'll tell you all the apps you need to download.
don't even worry about it. Don't even worry about it, man. But you know what? You and Kaz, it's going to be a nice union with you starting to do Kaz What's Poppin' guest spots. You know, you guys have plenty to talk about.
We just got like a 10-inch Chucky one the other day.
Like Chucky, why? Like murder doll, like, Chucky?
It's right there.
Yeah, what other
like,
Chucky
like
do
the
you
doll,
know?
Right?
Yeah, it's a big one.
So what other Chucky do you know? Nice. Child's Play 2.
That's like, yeah, why 2? Like, was there a distinct difference from the sequel to the...
Yeah, they're going to pull out the Bride of Chucky next.
What? That's almost like true to life scale, right?
I would say
he's
like...
He's a little bigger in real
life. Yeah,
bigger.
In real life, he's bigger.
He's like the size of a toddler.
Yeah. I like one of those My Buddy dolls.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, because that's what it's based
My
on.
My Buddy.
Yeah, that's what he's based on, I believe.
Sister.
Yeah.
Did you have one of those, Chris?
Did I have one of those? No, I was one of the cool kids.
He had a monster.
Oh, okay.
He had one of those monster. I did not friends. Have
my pet monster. Oh, get that out was here. Me.
I just got the My Pet Monster pop.
Of course you did. Of course you did.
It came with handcuffs, and I was like, oh, that's cool.
They broke immediately.
Yeah. Still cool.
They didn't cuff anything.
It cuffed him. Still cool.
No, I never got, Beth, I never got any of the cool toys when I was a child. Like, I wanted a lot of, my mom, not to say that my mom didn't get me things, she got me things, but she never got me what I wanted.
Right.
Like,
yeah, I never had any.
All I ever wanted was a Teddy Ruxpin, and I never got a Teddy Ruxpin.
I had one.
Sure you did. I had one. Privileged-ass Indiana welfare kids.
I was not welfare.
You know, we had the, there was like a Teddy Ruxpin like TV movie that happened, and I taped that off of TV and watched it all the time. That was my Teddy Ruxpin.
Dog, I used to have compilation tapes that I recorded off TV of all the holiday specials. It'd be like Transformers Christmas special, He-Man Christmas special. I used to record all them and watch them all year long like damn nerd.
My favorite.
I guess I wasn't the cool kid.
I think my favorite show growing up was the weird one. It was called The Wuzzles.
I remember it that. Had, it was a generic Popples.
It was. And there was like animals that were two different animals. Like I had one that was Bumble Lion. So it was a lion, but he had bumblebee wings. That was my favorite. I forget who else there was. But
Bumblebee. I don't even know what to say to you.
Right. And I had a Teddy Ruxpin. And the bottom jaw fell off and he's missing an eyeball. But tape still played.
Boobazooza.
Boobazooza.
Oh, like boy.
My favorite show when I was a kid was like the old school Batman. Like I used to watch that every day after like school.
The Adam West one, like old school?
The Adam West, yeah. Like they had it in reruns. I didn't see it. Like, black and white TV.
You weren't there in the 50s?
No.
Is that what you're saying?
But like we just found that's on like one of, like we have a Roku and it's on one of the channels.
Mm-hmm.
One of those free TV channels.
Huh?
Yeah, like one of those free TV channels on the Roku. They got some good stuff on there.
Yeah. So I've been watching it randomly, just, I don't know, because why not?
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
Those Adam West Batmans are, they're a lot, but I never watched them when I was a kid, and they are way better than I would have given them credit for, because they see, like, my idea of them was very, like, just beyond cheesy, and I just didn't have any interest in it. And I probably watched like two or three episodes, and they were, I mean, they're pretty good.
Yeah. I mean, they are super, super cheesy, but like some of the themes, I guess, are super adult for today's times, I guess. But there's one where Batman gets like drugged and he's like trying to save Robin. So he like jumps in his car and he's like about to take off. And then a police officer's like, you know, you shouldn't be driving.
Oh, wow.
I need to take a cold bat shower.
Save Robin. That's so weird.
That car was the wackest car, too, man. Like,
Oh, my gosh.
Greenlit that car.
Are you people crazy? That car was awesome. What are you, nuts?
From now on, your judgment is suspect, okay? Because you've said lots of questionable things tonight, and I don't know that I can let that one pass.
Like, that car is cool. Like, I am not a flashy guy. Like, I don't like doing anything extra for people to be like, what is that guy doing? But that car...
he's going to be a sports reporter or whatever. Yeah. What is that homeless guy?
I'm going to be a sports agent.
Yeah, that's what it is.
What is that guy doing?
I would love that car. Like, that car is useless. But I like that car because it's so, like, it doesn't even make sense. It's
probably responsible for global warming.
It doesn't make sense.
Single-handedly.
It doesn't have a roof. And then when you watch them drive up to a place and then just get out because it's just a car, it's amazing.
It's amazing. I feel like they were like bubbles. Like, where they got into seats, weren't they like bubbles?
Yeah, they were bubbles as little windshields in the front, little but then it was just open air on the top, and then they just were wearing capes and then just got out of a car.
It's a flawed design. I'm not a Batman fan. I'm not.
I mean, no one can blame you. Like, there is only, like, you know, there's Batman 89, and then everything just kind of falls short from there, except for the Batman animated series.
I mean, I liked Christian Bale.
I only saw those maybe the one time. Like when you when they come out and you watch them because it's like you watch them because it's Batman. I don't think I ever revisited them, and I remember not liking them, but like it wasn't like something where I'm like, man, that was awesome.
Iron Man or whatever, you know.
Again, that's just that's my.
I watched Gotham though, the TV series. That was good.
Yeah, we watched probably like 3 or 4 seasons of it, and then we just stopped for some reason. So we didn't finish it.
I know exactly why we stopped, because there were no stakes in that show. Like, you knew Bruce wasn't going to die. You knew Captain Gordon or whatever wasn't going to die. Mm-hmm. There was just like a handful of people that they would put in danger, and you're like, this is nothing.
Sounds like The Walking Dead.
Yeah, yeah.
Hey, did you guys ever watch Walking Dead?
Yeah.
We didn't finish it.
I think we watched up to...
like where they are messing around with Negan.
That's around when I tapped out too. Same. It was a little bit after that.
I think that guy's hot though.
That was
who doesn't Bethany?
Absolutely.
But like that. By the way, that show fell victim to like I bought like the first 3 like omnibuses of The Walking Dead.
Hold on. What's an omnibus?
It's like a collection of the graphic novels all combined into one giant, ridiculous, like not, it's not
like a compendium or.
Is that what I said? Is maybe it is the compendium. I have the Mask omnibus, I think. Is that what it's called?
When you say omnibus, I think of like a bust of like a head. And I'm like, what does that have to do with anything?
I thought you said on the bus. I'm like, where are you going?
Get on the bus.
So. I don't know what the difference between a omnibus and a compendium is, because I'm not that big of a dork, but like this, like the Mask, can you see that?
Yes.
So that is the omnibus of the Mask. And I guess it's like the first book. Huh?
It says just a big fat book for the people that can't see.
And for the people that can't see it also, like the compendium for The Walking Dead mm-hmm. is like, it's like a phone book of comics. Like, it's ridiculous.
Yeah, I have this. It's the Infinity Gauntlet. And it's all of the Infinity Gauntlet comics put into one book. So you could just read them all. But
yes.
It's not, I don't know what an omnibus is. You just dropped
it on there.
You dropped a crazy term on me, DJ.
Let me go ahead.
Do you want the definition, Chris?
Yes. Absolutely. Hit me with some facts, some hard hitting facts, because that's what I'm lacking.
An omnibus is a volume containing several novels or other items previously published separately.
That's what we have.
So what's
put together then? Well, let me Google it.
Because like there are many omnibuses for the Mask comic, but there's also like 4 compendiums for The Walking Dead.
Here's my guess. So like if say there's The Walking Dead, the main story, and then like say there might be a spinoff, like a Carol version, I think the compendium might compile all those together. So you have all of them in one place.
So it's like an enigma wrapped in a whatever.
Yeah.
There you go.
That's my guess. I don't know.
I'll say this. I read the compendiums for The Walking Dead, whatever they mean, whatever that means.
Beth's face says, shouldn't say anything because I'm about to read you what it is, DJ. Okay.
Please.
It's a collection of concise but detailed information about a particular subject, especially in a book or other publication.
And there you have it.
It's an encyclopedia.
It basically was the book was better than the movie situation also for The Walking Dead.
That's because what they say.
Spoiler alert, all the cool stuff happened in the, like, Rick got his arm cut off, like, immediately. Did that ever happen on the show?
No.
Not so long as I was there.
Because, like, when they went to, like, the first place, wherever they went, where that mayor was having, like, zombie wars at the football field or whatever it was, like, that dude's opening, his, like, opening gambit to Rick was to, like, grab him and cut his arm off. And that was like his deal.
I want a movie to come out tomorrow called Zombie Wars at the Football Field.
Isn't that what they did? They had like, what is it called? Like the Coliseum, but at a football field and with zombies.
You know what? See, I vaguely remember that, but I think I was really, really close to tap. And I think I had like 1 foot in at that point. I tell you what, the first 2 seasons were really good. And then when they got to the jail and they had the governor and like every episode was like, we're going to go to war. Well, now we're not going to go to war. Well, are we going to go to war? I don't know. We're back on for war. I'm like, this sucks, man. Like, just do it already. And they jerked off for an entire season about, are we going to fight the governor? And then they finally did. And then I'm like, all right, now what? And it's just like rinse, repeat, go on to the next thing where there's a new overlord type guy and then overthrow him and absorb his people and then go on to the next thing. I'm like, this sucks, man. I'm not with it.
It did suck. And by the way, Rick was also crazier in the graphic novel too, because like, remember when his wife, whatever her face was, died?
Yes.
And he, I can't remember, but I feel like there was like one moment where a phone rang and he picked it up and he answered it and it was her, and even though she was already dead.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. And well, in the graphic novel, like, he takes that phone with him because he gets phone calls from her. Dang. From time to time. And Michonne, like, that's when her and he kind of like start to get together, because mm-hmm. she's also insane, because she was like carrying around her, like, I think the zombie that she was carrying with her was her ex-boyfriend or something. Yeah. Like that. Or, okay. Yeah. And it, like, but she would still see him too. I can't even remember anymore. I just know it was way more interesting. And the show, I was like, okay, that's fine. It's a diversion from what is going. It's not a, you know, a direct whatever. But then it just went so far away that it was just, it just wasn't, the show sucks.
Who are you telling, yeah. dude? I am a Walking Dead truther.
I think my favorite character was Shane. Like the guy that got, it was the Punisher, yeah.
Yeah, he died quick too.
Yeah.
It was like, season two, I think they got him.
He was a jerk, but he seemed like he would make the hard decisions instead of looking at somebody and being like, it's my mom.
Yeah, as they're blue and they're like,
she's a bitch, right?
I got a voicemail from your best friend Riley. DJ is very popular, so yes, he does have a lot of best friends, and sadly none of them are me. He's friends with everybody else in the circle and he hates my guts.
Is there a reason?
It's just his way.
I have said that
oh, DJ, you mean the voicemail?
I will say that I'm gonna put this conspiracy out there that DJ Century is just Hunter from the future. Like, they are both house cats, and Hunter is just in his wild feral stage right now. But he will eventually, when he gets to whatever age DJ Century is, like, those two are the same person, I think.
They're like DB Cooper and Baron Trump.
Yep.
We have tiptoed about that topic like on three separate shows now. Eventually it's all going to come out, whatever we had to say.
The next thing you know, that's going to be trending on Twitter.
Well, we keep mentioning it, but we never talk about it. People are probably like, what are they talking about? DB Cooper and Trump.
Get Baron on the show.
that might be an okay get. Like, he's in Florida now, right? Like, we could probably work that out. I don't know what I would say to him, though, because I don't follow politics. So I'm like, I know nothing about you other than you went back in time, stole some money.
How old is that kid now? Do we know?
You would probably have a better guess than I would.
By the way, I thought he was 10, but he's like 7 foot 8. So I have no idea.
Well, the picture that Jason used for the cover for The Last Creatures, apparently that's him. But he looks like a small child. And I'm like, how is that the guy that's DB Cooper? Like, that doesn't make sense. I don't know. Things go over my head because I'm so uneducated.
And misinformed.
Let's hear from Riley.
Hello, hashtag hotline. This is your friend Riley. Now, this isn't really a question for the hashtag no offense show, but more of a question towards the entire inner circle extended universe. But the question goes like this. Why is, so as you know, Bobby Heavy, father of both Adam Simmons and Bobby Light, Bobby Light's a junior. Bobby Light's the youngest brother of three. Why did Bobby Heavy wait for his third child to make a junior? Isn't that usually like a first boy thing? You're like, this is my junior. This guy, was it that they ran out of names there? I guess we'll go junior on the third one. That confused me. This probably is a question for the Simmons & Moore podcast. But I wanted to call you, Chris Wuski, and ask. Maybe you had an answer. I don't know. You guys have a hotline, so I figured I would call, even though I'm calling yourself.
Interesting.
Well, I'm going to shut up and listen now. Shout out to Bobby Heavy's Loans.
Nice.
I don't know if we should check on the kid. I think he might be either drunk and or having a stroke. I think we should probably check on the kid.
That was either the drunkest call he's made in a long time or, yeah, definitely stroke heavy.
It was like 3 hours ago, so I hope he wasn't that drunk that early. Dutch, what say you? Why did Adam's dad wait three kids deep to make a junior?
Maybe they ran out of names and was just like, well, this will do.
That's definitely a possibility. I was leaning towards Adam and Kyle came out and he was maybe slightly disappointed and was like, fuck it, we're going to try for one more. And no matter what, that's going to be the junior. And it just happened to be Bobby Light.
Maybe.
That's my guess.
Oh, I have no idea.
I don't know why anyone names anyone anything. Like, I am the third. So I don't know, man. Like, I would not put that voodoo on another child.
But that would be weird fourth. If they skipped your brother and then named him the third. Or skipped you and then named your younger brother the third.
Maybe the first two were accidents and the third one was planned.
Maybe.
When
we found out we were pregnant with Logan, that was the first thing I asked him if he wanted to name him after himself. And he was like, no, I want his life to be better than mine. So I'm not going to curse him with my name.
That's true. I was like, I don't want to put my legacy on that kid. I want him to carve his own path. I don't want him to have to carry my name.
Are you named after your dad?
Me? No. No, I don't even really know my dad.
So there, you should have named him. You should have named him Christopher.
That's not my name.
See, like my dad and my brother's both name is James, but my dad's James Edward and my brother's James Michael. So it's like it's the same but different. He's not a junior, but still named after him. That's why Lucas's middle name is James after my dad, and then Chris's middle name is James. And then Logan's named after Wolverine. That? What?
Chris's middle name is James.
I would just talk with my hands.
I was going to say, my middle name is James. Is there something wrong with that? I don't get it.
No,
I
don't.
I feel like everybody's middle name is James. And then I was told recently that all girls' middle names is Marie.
Beth, can confirm?
No. Okay. But my sisters, like my mom named me Bethany, clearly. And then my sisters are Brittany and Brittany. And so when
hold on, Brittany and what?
Yeah, exactly. Brett. Ho, ho, ho. Brittany and Brittany.
Britt and Brett.
Correct.
Wow.
So whenever we were younger, our cousin used to call them Big Brittany and Little Brittany because he couldn't say Brittany.
That's got to be so confusing. Like, why would you do that to yourself as a parent?
Like, yeah, or your kid, like give them their own identity, like completely.
Yeah, that too. But I mean, like selfishly, as a parent.
I mean, she liked the names, I guess.
That's crazy. They should have formed like a pop duo or something. Like they should have marketed that.
No, they don't get along.
Oh, that could have been the gimmick.
Yeah, that was how Milli Vanilli actually came together originally. They knew they couldn't sing, but they're like, your name's Milli and my name's Vanilli. We have to do something.
I know that's not true, but it's going to be true. It's going to be true.
It was between real estate or starting a international pop band or whatever they did. And they were like, let's see if we can do it.
Dude, hey, say what you want about Milli Vanilli, but Blame It on the Rain is a fucking banger.
Blame It on the Rain. Do we ever know? I mean, I think we did, but do we ever find out like who legit was singing that and if they ever became famous?
Yeah, that was Seal.
No, it wasn't. Shut your mouth.
Seal. It was their background. Like, it was like the backup singers that were singing.
No, it was Seal. It was James Rodney Seal. And he went on to Kiss a Rose and Batman Forever or something.
How crazy is it that would Seal be as famous as he is if it were not for Batman?
Yeah, absolutely. He was
married
to that model and he's got the thing on his face. I mean, like, he's very rememberable.
Who would have cared that man existed? That song would not have, I'm telling you, that song would not have been as good were it not attached to Batman. It's a great song. Don't get me wrong.
Dude.
And any of his other songs?
Name three of his other songs. Go ahead. Name one of his other songs.
I know one.
Just say a letter that was in one of his songs. You can't.
Can I buy a vowel?
The first letter is
little known fact. He used no vowels in his work or in his song titles.
I don't know what that song title is actually.
Which one?
The one I was thinking of.
Kiss from the Rose.
Can't tell you.
The only other song I know, it's like You're Never Gonna Survive or whatever.
Yeah. I see, that's the one I knew.
So. Crazy, maybe that's what it's called.
Crazy, I think, is exactly it.
Yep. There get a go. Little crazy. Yeah. I was around in 92. I know a thing or two about a thing or two.
Whatever. If it's not Ace of Base, who cares?
Oh, they're the worst.
Like, I can just picture Chris like driving around listening to Tracy Chapman Fast Car.
I got a fast car.
With the windows down. You know what? Was it just me? Or like when you hear a song, like in your mind, do you create like a music video for that song sometimes?
Oh, for sure.
Buddy, let me tell you about how I thought I was going to be a music video director. Because I was like, I'm a visionary.
Fast forward to 2020 and MTV's not a thing anymore. And DJ's on the corner by the mall with a fucking poster board.
We'll edit your music video for money.
I loved MTV though in the 90s. Like, hell, I used to record music videos and then like watch them all the time.
TRL, or like, man.
Go ahead.
TRL, or they did like those beach parties or whatever.
Loved the beach parties. Mm-hmm. Like, I remember just like watching The Grind or whatever, and I would like dance with them. I loved that.
They're all in that pool. Nobody's hair got wet. It was amazing.
Dude, I recently, within the last couple months, showed Dutch the Paula Abdul video with Keanu Reeves. Do you guys remember? Remember that? It was like a full, like, full-length feature film. Like, it had like acting and like it was like
Keanu was in it.
It was a whole thing, and she's like, I never knew this was a thing. Like, dude, really? Paula Abdul was my first crush. Like, I knew this was a thing.
I've never heard of such a thing. That makes me think of when what was it, Chris Tucker did that Michael Jackson video that was like a 7-minute little like mini mafia movie.
Like, it happened like after Michael Jackson fell off.
I was thinking of the one though. Remember the one where he was like in Egypt and it was like a whole thing and he was
Remember the time?
Yes. Yes, exactly. I feel like after Thriller, he was like, I have to do like these big productions for everything that I do from now on because of this.
Oh yeah.
I mean, what was
And in that video, wasn't
which video?
Remember the Time. Like, there was a basketball player in that, I thought.
Was there?
Abdul Jabbar, Kareem
Abdul Jabbar. No, it was Eddie Murphy was a king or whatever, like a pharaoh or something. Yep. And I think Iman was like his wife.
Yes, I do remember that. I do remember that. I didn't remember Eddie Murphy though, but that makes sense. I mean, like,
was that Eddie Murphy? Maybe it wasn't.
The only music video of Michael Jackson's that mattered after Thriller, in my opinion, was the Black or White video, because that was
dancing with those Indians on top of that stage in the middle of like the prairie somewhere, like him and Kevin Costner are just like out there chilling with the wolves and shit.
When I saw that, I remember it was like on Fox. They were like the world premiere of the Black or White video by Michael Jackson, and saw those people like do it. It's black. And I was like, my brain melted out of my ears. I was like, this isn't possible. How are they doing this? I can't even see the cuts. It's amazing.
I think I remember exactly what you're talking about too, when it was on like Fox in the summer. It was like the world premiere Michael Jackson on Fox. Like,
and Macaulay Culkin was in it wearing some of the Mr. T starter set.
Of course he was.
Oh yeah.
And I'm not going to spend my life being a color.
Wasn't the guy from Cheers his dad? Video?
Oh yeah, yes. Norm was his dad in the video.
George Went, motherfucker,
space or whatever. Or didn't he get blown like back in time or something?
I don't know if he went back in time. Didn't his couch like land out there in the field where he was dancing with the Indians or the
Cowboys?
Did you guys like Cheers?
That was a little before my time.
I watched some of it.
I watched a little bit of it, but that was a little bit before my time because I was young enough to where I didn't get a lot of the stuff.
I knew Frasier was in it, and then the mailman guy, and then Norm, and then the bartender dude.
Yeah, Ted Danson.
Fucking one bitch.
Something Malone. What the fuck was his name? Sam Malone. He was slinging dick all over Boston.
Mm-hmm. Like, we didn't, it was before our time as well, like, but we just watched it randomly, and it's on Netflix.
No, I was gonna say that was like back in the getting DVDs days of Netflix.
Oh yeah,
Like, I actually, I think. Love days.
fun fact, Nicholas Smiklis still gets DVDs from Netflix.
Of course your imaginary friend gets DVDs from Netflix.
Dude, I should call him right now. It's his birthday. I should call him and say happy birthday and say, hey, yo, tell this guy that you exist and you pay $40-something a month for Netflix to get 10 discs at home at a time.
Yeah, no, it's crazy. Yeah, he's going to ride over to your house on Puff the Magic Dragon and guys are all going to...
Little do you know, that's what he calls his car.
Say my name. Bastion. Yeah.
He's got a luck dragon. It's crazy.
Yeah, and I listened back to Dragging the Table, which I thank you again for doing that because I enjoyed that episode thoroughly. And when we were talking about Sequest, the kid from Sequest was not the kid from goddamn Neverending Story.
He wasn't a Caillou?
He was in the second one.
The second one don't count? That didn't even come out in theaters,
It's not the same one from the first. He was in the second.
I heard that today and I was like, how did I let that slide? That's not the same kid at all in the slightest.
Listen, it's the same kid. And listen, if anyone is going to be trying to break apart the Neverending Story part two, like, shouldn't we still be having Neverending Stories? Like, shouldn't we be on Neverending Story 15 by now? It's never ending.
You know what? I don't even think I saw the second one. Did you ever see the second one?
No.
I remember renting the first one from the grocery store.
Bastion could have been the new James Bond. They could still be making Neverending Stories as to this day.
I think you're gonna get some hate for that. With the
The
James Bond slight. Bobby Moore is coming for you, player.
LOL. He can shoot me through that hole at the beginning of the movie if he can catch me.
I welcome it because that will take some of the heat off of me because I'm sick of listening to Sam PC and have them motherfucking me every episode for no reason.
I mean, listen, I was okay with I came in on GoldenEye. I feel like everyone our age did. Yeah. I had nothing for the Sean Connerys or the Timothy Daltons or the whoever else did it.
Roger Moore.
That guy. Pierce Brosnan. Pierce Brosnan was my boy, which was hilarious to see him act hard, but also have a Robin Williams in drag yell, "It was a run by fruiting." But then Daniel Craig was awesome. Like, he showed up, Casino Royale, awesome. And then there was the one with the guy, the No Country for Old Men guy. I think that was the one where I just had no interest in a sad, contemplative, I don't know if I can do this James Bond. Like, we watched the whole movie. I think it might have been, I don't know if it was Quantum of Solstice or whatever. I don't know.
No, I think it was Skyfall. I think that's the one that I watched in New Hampshire with them because that's when it sounds like when they were. I said he was setting Home Alone traps around the house, he was putting bolts in bags and tying strings and booby traps and shit. And then all the guys were coming in, and it was like, screws in the neck, tripwire, gotcha, bitch.
I would love if James Bond did that. Tripwire. Gotcha. Bang.
I am going to work on that screenplay as soon as this podcast is over. It's going to happen. And you're going to direct the music video.
I will direct the music video. I just need to, go on a long car ride in the passenger seat and look out the window. And I'll just listen to that song and I'll come up with the music video.
I like it.
Black or white?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
So you're going to remake Black or White as the Bond song for the upcoming, I don't even know what it would be.
What? What the next Bond movie would be?
Yeah, with the tripwire, got him.
It would be Macaulay Culkin. He would be the new James Bond. Like, they would, cut him up, put him in a suit. I say cut him up, I meant his hair.
Yeah, cut him up. Cut him up and put him into his suit. It got dark real quick.
I would watch that. I would, because by the way, it's been a while since we've had a good spoof movie. I would watch the Macaulay Culkin spoof James Bond movie. Like, that's the movie we all need right now.
That was such a thing in the late 90s, early 2000s with scary movies and not another teen movie and all that kind of stuff. And then it just went away. And I never even liked it. Did you like Scary Movie?
No. There was the other one too that was I don't remember. It was like that, but it was it's not the one. Is it Scary Movie? He comes and she sticks to the ceiling.
Yes. It was not another. They did all the not another teen movie.
I didn't know what you did last summer or something. Wasn't there one like that in there? Was that all tied?
Yeah, I think it had like a long name. I still know what you did last summer. Spit on your grave or some.
Interesting.
Yeah, it had a long title.
They had the Waylon guy in it.
Marlon, I think. Marlon was in it. I think
the closest we have come to a spoof movie nowadays, I feel like, is Pitch Perfect. Like, I feel like Pitch Perfect was
I'm going to stop you right there before you do something that you're going to regret, okay? Because Pitch Perfect is a modern cinema classic. Anna Kendrick is a fucking dime piece, and you will not disparage her on this podcast. So, watch your words. Proceed with caution.
She sucks.
She's a gift. But
she's a peach.
Can I tell you, I watched the Cup music video last week. Okay. I like Anna Kendrick.
Like that movie. I've seen Pitch Perfect than any straight 40-year-old man should ever have seen Pitch Perfect.
That is true.
But do you harmonize?
No, I don't like get down. I don't like get down like go interactively.
Go to the empty swimming pool and
yeah.
Have some battles.
I was going to say karaoke. Acapella battle in a drained pool. Like, fucking, whoa, I'm singing Ace of Base aggressively.
I'd be Bumper's friend.
This is so underground.
But it's not
edgy.
Are you telling me that's not like a parody spoof movie that people accidentally took seriously?
I mean, it might be. I don't know. But I always had a soft spot for teen movies in and of itself. And that's kind of like that. I mean, like, it's a college movie with a lot of kids and stuff. And, like, I don't know. I dig it. I like shit like that. And I like her. I watch her in everything. She has a series on HBO Max. I watch the whole thing.
What's the series on HBO Max?
It's like a girl thing, dude. It's called Love Life, man. It's like a rom-com. I watched the whole fucking thing, dude.
What was the movie? Was it on Netflix? That it was like a Christmas movie or Noel? Something?
No, it was on Disney Plus, and I watched it and loved it. Fuck you, DJ.
Yeah, that was cute. I liked it too. Like, I remember whenever I saw it on there, DJ's like, oh, Chris wants to watch that.
Newsflash, Chris watched it the day it came out. Multiple times. Hey, kids, want to watch this Christmas movie? No? All right, cool. I'll just start it in case you want to later.
Yeah. Dude, I know, was it last week or last episode you were talking about watching Soul, or was that just us in real life?
I think it might have been a blend of real life, and then I think I did ask Jody, but it never went anywhere. But yeah, I did bring it up.
That movie, I said to you, like, we watched it last week. That movie, like, I don't remember any kind of heavy messages like that when I was a kid.
Fantastic, though. Fantastic movie. Like, here's the thing. It's fantastic in what it is, and it's fantastic the way they executed it. But goddamn it, now I'm looking at Disney under that, like, scrutinous light now, because, like, I've dug up so much dirt on Disney. And I'm like, why are you putting all this stuff in front of us like this, man? Come on. Goddamn. It hurts me so bad because, like, we're such a big Disney family. Like, you know, we had our annual passes and we used to go twice a month to Orlando, to the House of Mouse. Like, we love the whole experience. And then, like, I found out, like, all the nefarious Disney shit. And it hurt me. It hurt me so bad.
Like, what examples? Like, what are you talking about?
Like, what was a big one that really shocked you?
There's a lot of just, like, hidden imagery, because Walt was, like, tied up. Like, Walt was a Nazi sympathizer, and he was tied up with, like, the Freemasons and, like, a lot of secret society type stuff. And he incorporated a lot of that into the parks and into the movies. And, I did a lot of research for an episode of Creatures while I had COVID. And I have the notes saved, but I haven't, like, looked at it recently, so I don't have it all, like, you know, top of mind. But there is a lot of it just has to do with, like, the imagery and stuff that they put in there, and the ties to, like, Jeffrey Epstein and things of that nature.
Oh, okay. Jeez.
Yeah. So you think you're trying to help that guy out, and not in him, but you know what I mean? Like, he was wanting to funnel children towards, you know,
lots of kids go missing at Disney World every year. Lots of kids go missing.
Alligators. We know that, right?
Dude. That's the best. I mean, I want to say that. Let me rephrase that. That's not the best. When we would go to Disney and we would stay at the resorts and we would go walk, like, on the paths or whatever, and every 6 feet, there's a sign that says, warning, alligators present. Like, after that kid got
I was like, yeah, put up some signs. That'll do it.
We Florida men really respond well to signs. We read well, and we follow those signs to the T.
Deej, that's a great segue. Well, actually, we're super late. Do you guys want to do Florida stories, or just do you want to skip it? I got some. I got some, but they weren't that intense this week.
Yeah, well, then we'll just skip it if they suck.
I mean, they don't suck.
Well, you said they weren't intense.
I had to do some digging.
All right, let's just skip. Yeah.
Skip it is. Guys, it's a pleasure. I could talk to you all night. I think my wife is tapping here.
I don't know what it is. My stomach is... I'm surprised I made it this long. I drank too much beer at work. I don't know what I ate. Something's
I don't know why she does this to herself on Fridays.
I really don't. I don't know why either. I'm like, I'm going to have fun, like, and then I forget I'm old.
So you drink beer at, like, an office?
Yeah. And that, there's a hook in that question. ... Are you hiring?
Fridays, because right now there's probably like, I don't know, 10 of us in the office because everybody's working from home pretty much. So I bring in beers on Fridays or margarita stuff, and then we just like have some cocktails like when 3 o'clock hits until it's time to go home, and then that's my day. So it's not every day, but we try to have fun. And then the boss walks by and he's like, what are you guys drinking? I never mind. It looks like juice. I'm going to go with juice. I'm going away now.
Yeah, get on, old man.
That's awesome.
Yeah, it's pretty fun. I like where I work. It's better than where I was. So
that's all that matters. Progression, mm-hmm. Moving on, ascension, right?
No, I won't drink any beers next Friday.
Well, we don't have anyone lined up for next Friday. Y'all want to come back next Friday?
We can turn this into a foursome again.
Yeah, this is, like I told DJ, I said, hey, the first time I think you guys were a little nervous coming over to the house that we were going to axe murder you. I was a little nervous. I was sick. You know, like things were what it was. I said, now it's just a double.
Now I'm sick.
It's just a double date now. Like, we're just hanging out. We're just four guys just, you know, here. And
people.
Oh, my God. Fucking literal.
We're all people.
Here. just four guys on the same team ready to have a good time. It's the double date. That's all.
True.
And I can't wait till our crab dinner, Beth.
Oh, me neither. I cannot wait. I freaking love that restaurant.
We're going to a crab spot.
Is it the Krabby's place over in Brandon?
Not the one that you saw tonight and made fun
of. It's that juicy seafood bar or something. I was like, oh.
No, it's not a bar.
We drove by Mr. and Mrs. Krabs. Have you guys seen Mr. and Mrs. Krabs by the mall?
Yeah, there's one in Tampa off of another road no one would know. Anyway.
We drove by there, and apparently their sign on the marquee said, like, Juicy Seafood Bar. And I was like, what is Juicy Seafood Bar?
I thought that was the name of the restaurant. And I was like, I've never heard of that.
There's a big sign for that on the highway, but I didn't know where it was. But they also have, like, still a big, like, do you ever drive on I-4?
Sometimes,
yeah.
Yeah. Have you guys seen those like big billboards for like Donald Trump 2020?
No.
And it's like there's like three billboards like all lined up together, and then there's like a big picture of him like
yes, no, yes, I did see that. It's like over like kind of like by Macintosh or like the Branch Forbes area. Yes, I have seen that. I laughed because I was like, haha, didn't age well, did it?
Yeah, that has been up for over a year though, I think.
Did you say that was a billboard?
It's like No, it's like not a whole like scene. Like it's like a
right. In somebody's yard?
Yeah, it's gotta be like someone's backyard, I would imagine.
I think I've seen it, but not to that extent.
I saw today, where was I driving? I was driving in Riverview somewhere. I was on the way home and I saw somebody had a Trump 2024 sign. And
well,
I was
they're
like,
impeaching him so he can't run again. That's why they're impeaching him.
That's happened a couple times, hasn't it?
I don't know.
Yeah, the second time. Oh, yeah. But I don't think it's gonna work.
By the way, I saw down Macintosh. I was driving down Macintosh, and I saw someone had this nice, huge, gigantic boat that they had wrapped in, like, Donald Trump 2020. Oh, here we go. Like, oh! And it's in their front yard still, which is amazing. Like, if I could stop and take a picture of it, I would. But I fear I would get shot by that man.
Right. 100% correct.
And in the great words of my friend Adam Simmons, if you put a political candidate on any article of clothing, lose my number.
I have a old dirty bastard. it says vote dirty 2004, I think.
There's an exception to every rule, DJ.
True.
did you guys see that Wendy Williams is saying that she slept with Method Man?
What?
Yes.
No. She's gross. Yes.
Like currently slept with him or back in the day?
Yeah, I don't know what year she said it was, but she said that they like met in a club because the Wu-Tang Clan was there and they were just hanging out. And then she asked if he wanted to go back to her place. And so they did.
Wow. And then, yeah, that works. That's crazy. gross, though. She's going through a divorce now. It's
gross, but like I love Method Man.
Like, hell yeah. I love all
I used to watch Wendy Williams when I was a stay-at-home mom.
Oh yeah,
mm-hmm. She's that. Do you know who that is, right?
Yeah, okay. Yeah. She's a man, baby. Yeah, she's very manly. Yeah.
Wait, Niecy Nash is who I'm thinking of. She's the one that's actually funny, right?
She is. She the one from Reno 911.
I think that's who I'm thinking of.
Yeah, she's like that.
Oh, yeah, those are two. Yeah, those are two completely different humans.
Yeah,
I know. I think the only thing I know of Wendy Williams is like she passed out.
Yes,
when she was wearing like a Statue of Liberty costume.
Yes.
And then she straight up was on her show and farted.
Yes. What?
Wait, that she farted after she like passed out?
No, I don't think it was after she passed out. I think it was a separate occasion. Mm-hmm. But I want to say I was listening to a podcast and they were playing the audio of her farting on her show.
Yikes.
Shut up.
But have you guys seen the little video whenever she passed out? Because she was wearing like a Statue of Liberty Halloween costume. Mm-hmm. And she just like starts like falling over and then is like,
she looks like she saw a ghost and then falls over.
Yeah.
How does that happen?
She was too hot, I guess. The costume was too hot. Right. She probably got like all those body shaper things on too. It sucks all the life out of you.
And as a band nerd, I can tell you she probably locked her knees. Never lock your knees.
And like as soon as 50 Cent saw that she was saying that about Method Man, he started going to town posting Instagram things like getting after Method Man about it, like trying to make fun of him.
What?
Yep.
Like what kind of things?
Like he posted a picture of Wendy Williams like bent over at the beach and he's like, how the F did this happen?
That's funny. That's rude.
It's mean. But apparently Wendy Williams and Meth had beef because she went on some radio show and was talking about his wife's cancer.
Oh. Like,
personal.
Nice.
Yeah, you don't do that.
And then come out and say that like you had relations.
Yeah. So anyway, if you guys want to end the show.
Sorry.
Now we have lots of stuff to talk about.
Yeah, I could go. You're one of those couples that I could sit and talk with all night, but the Duchess, I think she's done tonight.
Sorry.
Don't get drunk on my stomach. Show days.
What happens? And next time we gotta play trivia.
I told DJ, I don't know if he mentioned this to you, but I said, you better show up with a card to read me at least a few questions of trivia. And he was like, how dare you, sir? Never, not once going to happen. That's the sacred thing that I do with my wife.
Oh, okay. Well, then we did talk about it and I was like, we should do it.
I told you from now on, all things are going through Beth. There DJ, you're fired.
I'm sorry. Oh, good. You can take over social media and I will retire to the parlor.
Segway champ. Speaking of social media, where can we find you?
We are at Untrained iPod. That's EYEPOD on all social mediums, even Parlor. You can find us out there. We are there. It's amazing. On the app. You cannot use the app anymore, but I hear that the website's back up and we're just strong as ever as we ever were on Parlor. The website.
Her face. This is what I don't get when I listen to your show, because I can feel your look, but now I can actually see it.
And I don't know if you know this, Parler and the Inner Circle Podcast Network. That's where you can find us.
Nice. Hey, to whatever you think might be embarrassing, just know you're in the company of Jason Almy now. So, I mean, like... anything you can do, he can do better.
We never did make that phone call.
Yeah, and he texted me and said, hey, I thought you were gonna call me.
Oh, I feel bad.
Don't feel too bad.
There's a time frame here.
There is. Yeah.
Well, you know what? And we are the hashtag No Offense Show, but you know that because you click the play button. Go to htnos.com. Follow us on the socials at htnos. We're part of that Inner Circle Podcast Network. Guys, again, thank you. Or not thank. Well, thank you for agreeing, but welcome. You know, welcome to the club. Hell yeah. it's Simmons and Moore. It's Shit Happens When You Party Naked, The Hood Diner, The Plunge, Failing Hollywood, Untrained Eye, and The Creatures of the Night. Unofficially, but I mean, like, let's be real. This young lady is the Duchess Wetzky.
You're the real Wetzky everywhere.
And we are the hashtag No Offense Show.
Peace.
Bye.
Bye. Bye. Yeah.